You're probably wondering why I'm in a car for this review, right? Watch the show and it might make sense. Big Little Lies on HBO. Season 1 is already out, has been out for about 2 years now, and season 2 is about to drop. It's gonna premiere on June 9th. I quickly binged season 1 and I loved it. I loved every minute of it. And I think this is the next show you need to watch that's going to keep your HBO subscription after Game of Thrones. Feel really bad for all these people who have invested all their time into Game of Thrones, seeing as how the general consensus has been pretty disappointing for this last final season. Now, Big Little Lies has only been going for one season, and 7 episodes, short, sweet, and perfect. A masterclass at this storytelling. And it's directed all by Jean-Marc Vallée. The only film I know is Dallas Buyers Club, and that's on Netflix right now, so if you guys want to see something directed by the same guy, that's also a really great movie. It won Matthew McConaughey and Jared Leto, both a Best Supporting Actor and a Best Actor at the Academy Awards. What Jean-Marc Vallée, I think what he brings to Big Little Lies is, it's based on a book by Leanne Moriarty, which I haven't read, but I want to now, after seeing this show. Because I'm sure there's more to all of these characters, and a larger story. Really, really well done. The 7 episodes, what is amazing about having all of them being directed by the same person makes it so that he can leave something from episode 1 all the way until episode 7 and make it seem like one long movie. And that's basically what it felt like. Because when each episode ends, it's just like, alright, I mean, that was just a chunk of the story. And as the whole thing just kind of fits together really nicely as this one long story. And over 7 hours, it's really efficient at juggling all these different characters, all these different relationships, how these characters grow and change throughout these 7. I think it takes place like over a couple, maybe a week, very short amount of time as well. Shailene Woodley, Reese Witherspoon, Nicole Kidman, Laura Dern, Adam Scott, a lot of big names in this show, and none of them really, I don't think, overshadow each other, because they're all super good at their job, and all of these characters are impeccably well written. And that's the one thing about this show, is I think it really excels at something called verisimilitude. If you're unsure of the term, it's basically when film or cinema replicates real life or represents real life and is so realistic that you believe that whoever you're seeing on screen are real people going through real life-changing events or whatever happens to them through the course of the story. You believe that you are just watching real people have these interactions and go throughout. And that's what draws me to this show, and that's what I think will keep me coming back to this show. It's because it feels like they're not actors. Which, if the actors are doing the job right, it should feel like that. And the fact that it does means that they are doing their job even better. I think Reese Witherspoon and Nicole Kidman also helped produce the show, so they're definitely very passionate about this story and these characters. So it really comes through when you see the performances, because it focuses on these women. They're mothers in a school district in Monterey, California, and It also focuses on their kids and their husbands, and it's a very in-depth look at their life, and it shows how all of their lives are similar and how what it's like to be a mom. They're not doing anything different here. This is just a mundane show, all right? And what's amazing about the show is how it can take, and it's a testament, it's a real testament to the writers, because adapting, and also probably the book itself, adapting this book, whatever the writers did to write this show, they found a way to take the mundane, everyday goings-on, like normal things happen, like somebody's having an affair, somebody's beating their wife, somebody's kid's picking on somebody else's kid, and that, like, causes some divides, right? Very normal things. It's written in a way that's so compelling. It creates such compelling drama for you to watch that you can't help but be invested in these characters. And the actors just help sell the, like, with their performances, help sell these characters even more. And another thing to note is cinematography. The cinematography in this show, I think, is also really well done. Because Jean-Marc Vallée likes to use handheld cam. He's used it in Dallas Buyers Club a lot, and he uses it in this show a lot. And I really think that handheld cam lends itself to realism in film in such a way that not many other types of camera movement can really convey that sense of realism. So other places where handheld cam is most frequently used is in horror films, like found footage and everything, or like really badly edited action films where like there's handheld cam, and directors nowadays, I feel like they don't want the camera to be steady. They want to add mistakes. They want it to have that sort of someone else is watching. It's like through another person's eyes watching these events unfold. And I get that. But the thing is, you can have a steady camera, right? But I feel like I'm digressing here, but they tend to favor more shaky cam as opposed to a steady cam. And unless you can use a handheld or shakier cam effectively, then it kind of makes the whole viewing experience very messy. That's why I really liked the way this show was helmed, was because the realism that it adds with the shaky cam, it still adds enough of a little motion to keep things interesting and add that little bit of flair. So it's very expertly helmed, and the shakiness in the cam is used very cautiously and sparingly, which is what makes it even more interesting when it does occur. Another thing to note is the intro song is really nice. As one thing, it's not a big thing for TV shows, because like if I'm really binging something, or I'll just skip the intro, like I feel like most people will skip the intro, but if it's a nice intro, I'll watch the intro. Like, I would love to just watch it. I like music a lot, so if there's a nice, cool credit sequence with music, I'll watch it. And the song choice is great, and the way the credits are done are great. Kind of like I would keep watching the True Detective. True Detective is another great HBO show. True Detective's intro music, that was great. Or How I Met Your Mother, you know, Friends, you know. Season 2 starts on June 9th. You have now until then to catch up. And I highly recommend. It's not going to take you that long, and I think it's definitely worth it if you're looking for something new. If you still have your HBO subscription and you're like, all right, what else do I watch? Game of Thrones wasn't that great, or, you know, whatever the deal is. Oh, another thing, child actors. Child actors are really good in this show. So, like, most of the time, I think child actors in movies can be good in the movie. But in shows, they're, I don't know, generally not as good. The only good child actors as of late, notably. Like, on This Is Us, they have some pretty good child actors. And this one, they're very little. That's another thing. For how young they are, remarkably great. They have a lot of heavy subject matter to deal with and go through as young child actors. So I think they do their jobs wonderfully well. Honestly, there's nothing else. Like, I would give Big Little Lies a 9.5 out of 10 because I really liked the first season. And I'm really looking forward to season 2. Also, I heard that Meryl Streep is going to be in season 2. So I'm also looking forward to seeing her in this show. Another great character in season 1, Alexander Skarsgård as Nicole Kidman's husband. Great. Amazing. Amazing. And Adam Scott also as Reese Witherspoon's husband. Really, really underrated. I feel like he was the most subdued or restrained performance, but that was only because he was acting alongside Reese Witherspoon, and he kind of had to give her character room to kind of do her thing and be herself. Other than that, really, really good television. Highly recommend. I'm also watching season 1 of Barry right now. I'm almost done with that, and that's going great. Really, really like Barry. Barry's a lot shorter than Big Little Lies. Honestly, like half as short. Both shows, really good. So definitely check both of those out. I will be reviewing Barry shortly. Really looking forward to talking about that. Other than that, I will see all of you in the next video, where hopefully I'll be talking about Barry. And until then, have a good one.